everyone, Cynics here. This video is going to be targeted more toward beginners. So if you're relatively new to digital painting, it's quite useful to know what brush you should be using to maximize your learning potential. So we're gonna get into that. And by the way, I'll be using Photoshop for this entire video, which I haven't used to paint in for many years, so this might get ugly. First, it's important that we at least establish the properties that make up a digital brush. The most important distinction is in the edges. There are hard edge brushes and soft edge brushes. The border of a hard edge brush is solid and defined, while a soft edge brush just kind of fades off and creates no defined shape. While learning to paint, you can go ahead and throw away all of the soft edge brushes. Shape design and shape control are extremely important painting skills to master, so even if you're trying to paint something that naturally has a smooth gradient, such as the sky, it's still better to learn to represent that using appealing shapes and hard edges. The next aspect of digital brushes that you need to understand is the jitter. Jitter just refers to a change that occurs in the brush based on specific actions. This action could be velocity, angle, or any number of things. However, the only one we need to care about is pen pressure. So pressing harder or lighter with our stylus will alter the brush in some way. Most commonly, this is used with opacity, to make the brush more transparent when you press lightly, and also with size, to make the brush smaller when you press lightly. Brushes can have as many combinations of these features as they want, but we'll be keeping things nice and simple for now. Before I completely explain what brush you should be using, it's important to understand the most common struggles people have when beginning to paint. Coming from a background in drawing, most artists tend to focus on small brushes and approach digital painting as if they were using a colored pencil, trying to draw in the colors and tones. This often leads to colors and shading that feel soupy, formless, and chaotic. Ideally, you should be approaching painting with the biggest brush possible and only focusing on larger, chunky blocks of color and value. You should only work your way towards smaller brushes and lines once the painting is nearly complete. Luckily, it's easy to fight this beginner mistake before it becomes a bad habit. So make a conscious effort to keep yourself from using small brushes, and turn off that size jitter. Otherwise, you'll just be pressing lightly to make thinner strokes everywhere. You really don't need it. Get comfortable seeing the world in shapes instead of lines. And if you're completely new, start extra simple. Just do studies with a simple, large, hard edge brush, no jitter, and try to keep it to just two or three values or colors. It's easy to work your way up if you build a good foundation. I'm going to be doing this quick example of what it's like to paint from imagination with a simple round brush and no jitters. With no other options, you might start finding that the only way to make something that looks decent is by both picking interesting colors and also creating unique shapes wherever you can. You know how it goes, limitation is the mother of creativity. Try to focus on combining different areas and unique ways to form larger shapes. It can be frustrating and annoying, but do your best to limit yourself to the largest brush you can. After you've spent some time doing studies and paintings with these training wheels on, maybe you're ready to make some fancier art. Well, we're still not going to worry about that size jitter, but it is time to finally turn on the opacity jitter. I'm going to try and prove that you can achieve anything you want using the lamest Photoshop round opacity brush. I do recommend watching my Painting Like a Sculptor video if you haven't though, but to sum up those techniques, I can use this simple round opacity brush to cut hard lines and smooth them out into the other direction using pen pressure. Cutting out hard edges and smoothing values into other values is the only thing you really need to be able to do to create anything you want and really show as much form as your heart desires. I can even doodle some lame skull face over here just using the hard edge and opacity. I will be entirely honest though, I hate round brushes. If you can get yourself a nice hard edge square brush or triangle brush and just set the opacity jitter on, that could potentially be an even better learning brush. Oh well, regardless, all I have at the moment is this horrible round brush, but I'm still going to let you know that this is the only brush you need to go from being a beginner into being a professional. Then again, once you hit the intermediate levels, you might find brushes that provide you with fun shortcuts or other stylistic options, but in theory, there's no real limit to this brush. And in order to prove that this is really the only brush you need in order to get good at painting, I'm going to make some art using only this basic brush. I'll just zoom past the early stages, but I made a quick sketch here and I blocked in my base colors. I do need to lighten that line art into a less harsh tone, so I'll just make that a nice warm tone and then merge things together. Now I can just render away with this big dumb brush. Of course, having a good feel for colors and values will take you a long way, but as far as the brush goes, I'm just trying to use it as if I would use any other brush, picking places to make harder edges and then smoothing them out. You can use Alt to color pick a lot if you're having trouble smoothing things out. That might make it a little bit easier, just color picking into your gradients and everything. I will say, the smoothing process and color mixing is not nearly as convenient as it is in my normal workflow, but that's something I can just work through. Actually, what I'm really missing is having a color wheel right about now. I know you can download a color wheel plugin for Photoshop, but I don't have any custom stuff installed. Color wheels are incredibly superior to being stuck using these sliders. Anyway, the painting process is quite similar to what you've seen explained in most of my other videos, but I did try to make this shirt with lots and lots of folds in it, and also include an interesting hand in there. To be honest, I got a bit carried away with the hand. I don't know if there's a way to make hands look anime, but I just got into the zone and rendered it out pretty realistically. It might look a little strange next to that simplified face, but it was really fun to paint. I'm not sure what that gesture is even supposed to be. It just felt like a playful salute or something. In case you're wondering, my idea for this character was that she's a cadet in my little fictional mech organization, Chroma Corps. So she is a Chroma Corps cadet. That has an appealing alliteration to it. Anyway, I wonder if I should stop giving every character I draw long thumbs. I keep forgetting that my thumbs are just freakishly long and it's not normal. Oh well. Back to the clothing, I always liked the way Lion Decker did clothing folds, so I think my brain was aiming for something like that. The glossy looking highlights near all of the folds are definitely an homage to that. I think the best tip I can give for clothing is to approach it as if the cloth were actually a hard surface design. Sometimes I imagine it as being made of paper, like a complex origami design or something. That can help me get in the right mindset to focus on hard edges and large angular shapes. And I think I should give an extra disclaimer here. I know that the boobs aren't in the right spot, they're flying up to the top of the ribcage, but in my humble defense, it felt like it would give her a nice peppy energy. Like she just energetically adjusted her posture and they were mid-bounce or something. I don't know, it just seemed like it helped the pose, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. Alright, let's just wrap things up. I'm not super happy with parts of the clothing folds, but overall, I think it worked out well enough. I decided to blow up one of my old mech paintings and threw that into the background. It's a bit matchy with the colors, but it kind of works. I definitely like the colors of the cadet outfit. I would probably bring back the hat color on the lower body clothing if I ever feel like drawing this character again. I'm getting a bit off topic, but I guess that's about everything I have to say about beginner brushes. Now you can go off and master digital painting with just this one basic brush, and maybe someday you can start worrying about custom brushes and other stuff. And maybe, just maybe eventually, you can even be cool enough to use a soft edge brush. We'll see. Okay, it's time to end this video. I managed to make a painting in Photoshop with just the opacity round brush, and now I can return to my beloved painter. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you got something out of it, even if you're not a beginner, but I hope the beginners especially got a lot out of it. And I'm going to close this video out, as always, with a big thank you to all of my Patreon supporters. You guys are really great, and you make these videos possible, so thank you. See you, everyone.